Hi there, this is Mr. Weyberg, and I want to look today at the if-then-else-if statement. Specifically, I want to take a look at a specific case where we have logic rules that are not expressed correctly, and the result gives us a logic error. And then we'll look at different ways of how to fix that. So I first of all want to run this program that will give us a logic error. Then we're going to look at it, figure out what's wrong with it, why it doesn't work, and look at some different ways as far as how to fix it and make it correct. I have this program written. It's a test score average. We're going to enter in three scores and then click calculate, and we'll find the average of those scores. So I'm going to go ahead and run that and just show you what happens. So we enter our test scores. I'm going to enter in 40, 40, and 40. And you'll notice here that it tells me my average is 40, but it says I've got an A, and then it tells me to keep trying. So there's obviously something wrong here with test scores of 40 giving me an average of A. So let's take a look at the code and see what's going on. And you'll notice some things here that I got this from a resource that I have, and just the naming conventions that they have for their labels and things are different than what we're using, but that's okay. So what we've got, we have our scores as singles, and then our average is also a single. This is something that we haven't done yet. It's called a try-catch statement. It's just a way of catching errors and working with errors. But you get your three scores, and then you find your average, add them all three together, and divide by three, and then change that text of your label. Your label average text, you change it and put your average in there. Now, this is the logic, and this is correct because it's always going to generate a letter code, letter grade of A. So it starts off, and this is just a series of if-then statements. Okay, it is not a if-then-else-if type of logic. It's just if-thens all strung together. So we check. If single average is less than 60, then our grade is an F, which in our case it was. So it should stop right there. Okay, but we continue on. Then we say, well, if it's less than 70, then we have a D. Well, it's still less than 70, so it changes it to a D. If our average is less than 80, then we can change it to a C, which it does. Then it checks. If it's less than 90, change it to a B, which it does. And finally, it's less than 100, so it changes it to an A. So there's incorrect logic here because it is always going to give you a letter grade of A. Now, one way of fixing this would be to just change the order of all those if-then statements. So I'm going to do that first, and we'll look at that and see how it works, and then we'll come back and we'll look at the if-then-else-if way of doing this. All right, so you'll notice here I've changed this. Now I have my 100 being checked first, and then 90 looking for a B, and then my C, then my D, then my F. So now when I run this and I use the same input, 40, 40, and 40, and calculate my average, it gives me my correct average and it tells me my letter grade is F. So I changed that. All I did is I changed the order and I still have all of my if-then statements separately. Okay. Now, from a computer programming aspect, this works. It's fine. It is not very efficient, though, because you have to go through and check every single statement. Now, this is pretty fast, but if you're thinking in terms of a huge decision-making thing, like maybe Google has or something like that, if you have to make every single decision separately and each one takes a split second and you've got thousands and hundreds of thousands of decisions, it is going to slow down your process. So you want to make this a lot faster, and as soon as you get something that works, you want to stop your decision-making process and go on. So that's what I'm going to show next, is using this same decision process using an if-then-else-if type of logic. All right, now you'll notice that I have the same sort of structure, and I have my average is less than 60, my text is F, else if it's less than 70, then it's a D, else if my average is less than 80, then the text is C, else if the average is less than 90, then it's a B, else if my average is less than 100, then my text is A. And notice this is a less than or equal to 100, so 100 also gives us an A. So some things that you want to notice is that we're using the else if. So as soon as one of these things becomes true, it ignores the rest. So if we have an average that is less than 60, our grade becomes F, and everything else below that is ignored. So all of this would be ignored. If we have a grade that is 75, we look, is it less than 60? No. Else, is it less than 70? No. Is it less than 80? Yes, it is. So it would change our text to C and ignore all the rest. So this is very much more efficient than our previous code, because as soon as we get a correct answer, it stops doing the checking. So I'm going to run this just so you can see what happens. We go 40, 40, 40, check it, and it's correct. If we change this one to 100, and that one to 60, get our average, now it changes it to a D. If we change that to 100, calculate our average, we've got an average of 80, which is a grade of B. So it is now working correctly with that different logic. All right, we got one last little thing that I want to look at here. What happens if we enter in three test scores that are all over 100? We haven't done anything with that. It's still okay. It gives us an average of 120, but notice there is no grade given for us. So that's something that we want to look at and see how we can capture that thing. What we need to do is put on what is called a trailing else. So I'm going to put one last else statement there. And my last else, the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to say label grade.text equals invalid. Just so we capture that last case that, you know, something here isn't right. Everything's not working correct. So we've used this last else case just to say we're going to capture anything that just doesn't make sense. So now when I run this and I enter in my 120, calculate my average, got an average of 114, it's an invalid grade. So something's wrong with it. So I just wanted to show you that. Other thing that I want you to look at with this program, notice the use of comments to tell what's going on in the code. So it's really easy for you to look at it and say, well, I know what we're going to do. Okay, this procedure calculates, displays the average test score. If the score is high, it displays a congratulatory message. Here, get the test scores into variables. Calculate and display the average. Calculate and display the letter grade. If the score is high, give the student praise. Otherwise, give some encouragement. So it's very, very nice to have those comments for somebody else looking at your code to understand what is going on in your program.